a trip to the city of Caserta to connect with CSA EX-CANAPIFICIO, Centro Sociale de Caserta, an organization that helps refugees with social issues, advocacy, lawyers, medical care, counseling. We met with them and we networked with them, we talked with them, where they explained what their initiative is all about. For us, it was quite shocking. Despite my experience in Italy for a while, I never knew that that center, Centro, existed. And they've been there since in the early 90s. And they started in early 2000 to start helping refugees. And then we spoke with their spokesperson, Brother Prosper, who gave us an insight into what the organization was doing, had been doing for refugees. We also had the initiative to investigate very well to find out what was really going on. We were able to meet with sisters and brothers who explained the benefits they've been benefiting from this social center for the past 1 year. We met with a sister that I knew in Libya for a while, and I met her, we had a chat, and she explained how they've been helping her to support her accommodation. They pay the rent, they give her a monthly fee of about 300 euros, they finance her education and her internship. She's learning a trade, she's learning to be a caterer, because she was a caterer in Nigeria, and she's trying to be a caterer, also have a shop, a restaurant. And they promise after the graduation of her course that she will be given a loan of about 10,000 euros to develop a project, a restaurant business, so that they could see the impact. We also spoke with a brother who was a tailor. He sews clothes, and they also promised him some fees, about 15,000, to start up a fashion outfit in Naples, in Caserta there. So this was for us shocking that this existed, and we saw more hundreds of people outside. It was a meeting day for them, a busy day. It was on a Wednesday. I think they used to have their general meeting and also other counselings and medical care assistance on that day. It was a day to meet the lawyers who were not being paid for anything. It was a day to meet the doctors. The building, the facility was an abandoned factory that was occupied years ago. And they've been there since the early 90s, as a matter of fact. And they've been doing a great job to support the refugees and the migrants in the Caserta and Campania region of Italy. This, for us listeners, is quite shocking that this existed, and they've been successful at it for a while. Listen to the interview by Brother Prosper, their spokesperson. Hello, Refugee Radio. We are live in the city of Caserta, part of our European and Italian tour. And we are here at this organization. We are talking to one of the principal people in this organization. And we are talking to Brother Prosper, who is going to explain to us what this organization is all about. Hello, Brother Prosper. You're welcome to Refugee Radio Network. Right.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Brother Prosper, please, what exactly is this organization all about?
Yeah, actually, the organization is about to fight for our rights. As you have heard, many negative reports concerning immigrants and refugees here. We decided not to fold our arms and then listen to them to blackmail our image. And actually, nobody decided just to come here voluntarily. We were persecuted by conflict and everything. So coming here, we know the reason why we are here. We are here to seek asylum and everything. So the report, the negative report they pass against us over here are not true. This is the reason why we decided to come together as people that are facing the same kind of a problem, to understand ourselves and to really define who really we are, to oppose what they think we are. That is why we formed this movement since 2002.
Yeah. What was the name of this movement?
The name of the movement is the Movement of Immigrants and Refugees in Caserta.
Okay, and because this is your organization, it's like all the other places we've been to. In France, we've been to Calais, we've been to Saint-Papier, and it's the same struggle. Even in Hamburg, we have the Lampedusa in Hamburg fighting for the same thing you are fighting for here.
Yeah.
But most of these organizations we are talking about are quite new to your own.
Yeah.
And I think this is the reason why I see
something different here than all those places that I've been to.
Okay.
I've talked to people who said this organization has helped them for schooling, for work, for internship, for social assistance, medical care. And how has been the response from our brothers also?
Yeah, actually, all their response are very positive because from the beginning that the movement was not existing, a lot of lawyers has taken advantage over them. Number one, concerning their regularization of the documents and everything, they duped them one way or the other. Most of our brothers also entered into many problems that they supposed not to enter just because they were denied the permit of stay. But we found out that those things are, going against them. So when we formed this organization, from there, many lives have been transformed. They are happy to be members of the movement. They are happy for the results. Especially every year we demonstrate and we display our feelings to the public to achieve our goals, which actually you have already mentioned, professional school, Italian language school, and then the documents per se, and a lot. So it has made a lot of people even travel to the other places to find work, which then they didn't know they could make. And now we have the school, the project, and everything. It is helping a lot. Yeah.
And Brother Prosper, in a nutshell, the final word about the way out for we refugees, we migrants in Europe, and what the European citizens should expect from us.
Okay. Now, the European, I always talk to the televisions, a lot of the journalists come, and I told them that actually we have been a help. Though we are refugees, but in Italy per se, they did not treat us or they did not see us as refugees. But in other words, they are seeing us as a normal immigrant. Why? Because refugees end up of working, paying tax, making contributions to the country and everything. So actually, they have to expect that we are not here as problem people, but we are rather here even turn the other way to help or to contribute to the boosting of the economy of the country. Actually, that is it. For example, I work, I pay my insurance, I pay my tax and everything, I pay rent and everything. So I believe I'm making a contribution to the country.
Exactly. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Okay, keep it locked on Refugee Radio Network. Love freedom, love life.